President Yoweri Museveni has paid tribute to Honorable Simon Peter Alepei, the National Resistance Movement chairman for Karamoja sub-region. Simon Peter Alepei died in a road crash along the Igangambale Highway on Tuesday morning. In a press conference held at the NRM Party head office, the NRM Party Secretary General, Honorable Richard Todong, conveyed the President's directive to accord Alepei a state burial.
We need to thank His Excellency the President of the Republic of Uganda for according our colleague an official burial. And this is extremely exciting because even if it's in the bad period, we feel he's being honored well for the service that he has rendered the country and the party.
Members of the NRM Central Executive Committee, SEC, and NRM party members gathered at the Chaddondo office to pay tribute to the fallen SEC member. The late Simon Peter Alepei is expected to be buried following the program laid out by the NRM party.
Following day of Friday, the body will come to the party. The whole Friday is for the party. Since he was a party leader, the party members will pay their tribute, and therefore we thought it should start by having a SEC meeting in the morning for like an hour or two to allow his colleagues who are SEC members to pay their tribute.
Leaders of Parliament, who include the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, Leader of Opposition in Parliament, Joel Senyonyi, Government Chief Whip, Hamson Obua, Committee Chairpersons, as well as the Prime Minister, Robinah Nabbanja, today held a closed-door meeting to plan for what motions to be debated during the final year of this Parliament. According to Hamson Obua, during the meeting, Government tabled 66 bills that they want to be debated during the final year of this Parliament.
The calendar in principle is to handle businesses that government has brought before Parliament, but also to indicate when Parliament will be going on recess for members to plan in advance. There is no specific matter to say on this day we are discussing corruption, no.
According to the committee chairpersons, during this closed-door meeting, emphasis was put on transparency during committee sessions.
Why do we take long for the business committee to see? Because the business committee is the one that sets the agenda of the House. Now, when that committee takes long to sit, that means, you know, work of Parliament gets to be hampered. And so we agreed that we need to be meeting at least quarterly.
U.S. President Joe Biden returns to the White House after nearly a week in isolation with COVID at his Delaware Beach house, during which he made his shock exit announcement. Biden has tested negative for COVID and his symptoms have resolved, the White House physician said in a letter, as the president headed back to Washington 2 days after ending his re-election bid and endorsing Vice President Kamala Harris. The 81-year-old president tested positive for COVID on July 18th, while visiting Las Vegas, and was self-isolating at his Delaware residence after experiencing mild symptoms. The president spent nearly a week recovering from COVID in Delaware as he weighed his 2024 candidacy, ultimately dropping his campaign and preparing to address the nation about his decision not to seek another term in office. Biden is now in Washington and is expected to address the nation tonight about his vision for the final few months of his term.